coronavirus myth busted.
At the top of the list, the 5G network. There's a group of people who believe 5G's radio waves lower our immune systems, making it easier for the virus to take hold. Some Brits actually burned down a bunch of 5G towers.
That's just nonsense. Dangerous nonsense as well.
The radio waves from 5G are not strong enough to affect the immune system, and there is no way a 5G infrastructure could transmit the virus. 5G does not give you COVID-19.
Mythbuster.
A social media post is doing the rounds with a simple self-check test for the virus. One of the claims, if you can hold your breath without coughing for 10 seconds, you don't have fibrosis or scarring on the lungs, and that means you don't have COVID-19.
No, there is no science behind the fact that if you can hold your breath for 10 seconds that you don't have COVID-19. People with COVID-19 in 80% of cases can have a very mild illness, mild enough not to be hospitalised. Therefore, this would not hold up to that.
Mythbusted.
The same list also claims UV rays kill the virus. So if you plonk yourself in the sunshine when it's 25 degrees or hotter, you won't catch corona.
There are a number of tropical countries where there have been outbreaks of COVID-19, where the temperatures are well above 25 degrees. And of course, the internal temperature of our body is 37 degrees, and the virus seems to like that just fine. Sunshine does not kill coronavirus.
Mythbusted.
There's also a lot of advice about the virus-killing properties of hot water. Drink it every 15 minutes. Don't drink water with ice. Have it with drinkable silver, essential oils. Gargle it with bleach.
Do I really have to tell people not to gargle bleach?
Yeah, sorry.
So bleach is a no. What about garlic?
Garlic is bad for vampires, worse for a first date, but has no effect on the coronavirus.
Mythbusted.
Last but not least, the best way to kill coronavirus germs is to spray yourself with chlorine or alcohol. Bring on the champagne showers!
Yeah, hold off the champagne showers because that will not kill the coronavirus. So we know that alcohol does kill viruses with envelopes, like the SARS-CoV-2 virus, but we generally need alcohol levels of over 60%. And if you take a really strong drink, like vodka, that only has 40% alcohol. So good for a drink, but lousy for SARS-CoV-2.
Mythbusted.
For some, it's a bitter glass full of bleach to swallow, but the safest advice right now is the stuff that comes from genuine health professionals. Stay at home as much as you can and keep washing your hands.
Evidence-based advice approved.
We all know Susie's not going to waste vodka on coronavirus, but...
No, I'm not.
But being a bit serious about it, there are people that, including me, with some of these things that get ruled out, that you do hear and you think are right. You need to get this right, don't we? We need to hear from people like Sanjay. I feel really bad for him, actually. He gave me his mobile number after the show, and I've been badgering him every week during virus, trying to find out about things that I'm concerned about.
Yeah, that was a huge mistake.
Yeah. I mean, asking for advice is one thing, but those nudes you've been sending is too much, PVO.